Hello and good morning to one and all.
Hey Shalom, you look like you're in a good mood.
Certainly, Tarun.
Oh wow, I haven't felt that way in months, you know, ever since this COVID situation popped up. So many bad things. We couldn't go to school, we couldn't meet our grandparents, wearing those masks and those stuffy face shields. Ugh! And don't get me started on all the Fortnite games I've missed when my friends would come home.
Yeah, that's true. You know what? I was just like you, totally fed up of this lockdown. Until I stopped to think for a second and realized just how blessed we truly are. You see, God has given us so much time to spend with our families, so much time to reflect, reinvent, and reimagine ourselves, so much time to learn new skills and hobbies, and so much time to appreciate all that God has really given us.
Oh, wow. That really hit me. I promise that from now on, I will begin to thank God more than ever before.
That's wonderful, Tarun. Gee, we've reached that exciting time of the year.
What's that, Shalom? I don't get what you're excited about.
Oh, yes. Have you forgotten?
What have I forgotten?
All right. Let me give you a clue. We're in the month of December and there's a huge festival that's coming up.
In December? Huh?
Oh, the 25th of December.
Oh my, Christmas! Christmas is actually here! But alas, so is COVID. Not surprised I had a loss of memory.
Well, let's not dwell on that. Christmas will always be Christmas. And it's up to us to think of the essence of Christmas, the spirit of Christmas, the ways to celebrate it. Remember, it wasn't an easy beginning when Christmas first came to light.
I remember my grandmom used to narrate the story of Christmas to me, and I never got tired of hearing it.
Just a thought. Can you do me a favor, Tarun?
Oh, sure. What is it?
I'd love to hear your grandma's narration of the story of Christmas.
Definitely, I'd love to do that. It goes like this.
Hush, shh, there's a baby, ooh, ah, in the manger, hush. Baby Jesus, ooh, ah, there's a danger that we're going to wake him up. He's such good news, we can't shut up. We want to sing with the angels, heavenly sound. Shout with the shepherds, tell what we found. Worship with the wise men, bow right down. Jesus is born and he's such good news, we want to sing with the angels, heavenly sound. Shout with the shepherds, tell what we found. Worship with the wise men, bow right down. Jesus is born and he's such good news, we want to hush, shh, there's a baby, ooh, ah. Ooh, ah, there's a danger that we're going to wake him up. He's such good news, we can't shut up. We want to sing with the angels, heavenly sound. Shout with the shepherds, tell what we found. Worship with the wise men, bow right down. Jesus is born and he's such good news. We want to sing with the angels, heavenly sound. Shout with the shepherds, tell what we found. Worship with the wise men, bow right down. Jesus is born.
Christmas is a time of joy and celebration. But what is Christmas and why do we celebrate it? This was the question that two little children called Mia and Jack asked their grandmother Nani on the eve of one Christmas.
Nani, Nani, what is this festival called Christmas? Why do we have Christmas?
Well, said Nani, let's sit down near the fire and I will tell you why we celebrate Christmas. Once upon a time in the land of Nazareth, there was a girl called Mary. One day, while she was working in the kitchen, an angel appeared to her and said, God has blessed you and is pleased with you. Mary was very surprised by this and wondered what the angel meant. The angel said to her, Don't be afraid. God has been very kind to you. You will give birth to a baby boy and you will call him Jesus. Mary was very afraid, but she trusted God. Let it happen as God chooses, she replied to the angel. As the days passed by, she was married to Joseph, and they traveled from Nazareth to Bethlehem on a little donkey to help them in the journey. When Mary and Joseph reached Bethlehem, they had trouble finding a place to stay. Every house was full. Every bed was taken. Finally, they found one innkeeper who agreed to give them a place in the stable where the animals slept. That night, Mary gave birth to a baby boy in the stable, and he was kept in the manger. This little boy was then named Jesus.
During this lockdown, every element of our lives has been transferred online, including our music learning. Here is a small presentation of one of the most popular Christmas carols, Silent Night, on virtual keyboard, a new virtual instrument.
In the hills and fields outside Bethlehem, shepherds looked after their sheep through the long cold night. Suddenly, an angel appeared before them. And the shepherds were surprised. But the angel said, "Don't be afraid. I have good news for you and everyone. A king is born today in Bethlehem, and you will find him lying in a manger."
Thank you.
on that night, a bright new star appeared in the sky. Three wise men in faraway countries saw this star and knew that a great king was born. They followed the star to Bethlehem to see the newborn king. Each of them brought him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And so, my dear Mia and my dear Jack, people all over the world celebrate Christmas to celebrate the birth of Jesus. It is the time of hope, joy, and peace on earth.
Sharing that with all of us, Tarun. I bet we all loved it. A wonderful reminder of Christmas and where it all began.
I'm so glad you all liked it. I've definitely gotten into the Christmas spirit now. You know what, Shalom? I know we're all missing meeting and wishing each other, as well as the usual festivities of Christmas. The things around us have undergone such a transformational change. But if you only realize that the first Christmas was not an easy one either. If you notice, it was a story of survival, a story of strength, and most importantly, it was a story of hope. Let us look back and take inspiration and draw strength to face these uncertain times.
I'm glad you shared your realization of the true significance of staying optimistic and happy during these terrible times.
Now that all of us know the Christmas story, it's time to hear a few words from our dear director, Reverend Father Crispino, and our dearest principal, Mrs. Meena Saldana.
Hi friends, In a few days, we'll be celebrating Christmas. If I were to ask you a simple question, what is Christmas? I'm sure the first answer that I will get is Santa Claus. Then Christmas decorations, the Christmas tree, Christmas gifts, Christmas greetings, and not to forget the Christmas sweets. Yes, all these things remind us of Christmas. But Christmas 2020 is a different Christmas because of the pandemic. And if one thing the pandemic has taught us is to get used to be different. So what is going to be different this Christmas 2020? Just three things. First thing is the pandemic has helped us to get back to our basics. What is the essence of Christmas? The essence of Christmas is the birth of Jesus Christ. Christ is the center of Christmas. 2000 years ago, if a virgin Mary had to go and tell her husband who was going to get married to her that she was already with child, it would be something different and unheard of. But as they say, with God, even the impossible becomes possible. If a year ago I had to tell you that school would be closed for a whole year, that you would not be able to come to school, you would say it is impossible, we don't believe. But looking back at this whole year that has gone by, the impossible has become possible. And we have got used to this thing being different in our life. The second thing about Christmas is family. The pandemic has helped us to come closer to our families. And this is a beautiful opportunity for all of us to celebrate Christmas first and foremost in our families, to spend more time celebrating Christmas with our family members. Christmas is a time when people from all over the world come and celebrate Christmas with their families. And finally, Christmas is all about caring and sharing. God our Father thought about the world and shared His only Son with us human beings here on earth. And so every Christmas we reach out to people who are less fortunate than us. The pandemic has brought suffering and misery to a lot of people around us and in the whole world. May this Christmas help us not only think about our own pleasures and our own enjoyment, but also to reach out especially to those who are less fortunate than us. I'd like to wish every one of you, parents, staff and students, a very happy Christmas 2020. Thank you.
Dear children, parents and DBI staff members, 2020 started off well. Loads of expectations, lot of excitement. Our first batch of IGCSE was set to stamp their exit from school. We planned a warm send-off before we realized we were hit by the novel coronavirus. Total uncertainty in the air, abrupt lockdowns, and suddenly we who moved around as free birds were locked in our golden cages. The tunnel seemed long, narrow and twisted, not a glimmer of light, a sense of helplessness, hovered above us, but our spirit did not let us down. Together we innovated, supported each other, reached out in humanity to the less fortunate migrants, and with a sense of purpose, we moved ahead. As I look back at the calendar, I found that every one of us lived in the true spirit of Christmas. Through our humane actions like Guptan, or following the kindness calendar in the last month, or it was participation in the school activities, be it mathalon, be it the debates or the exhibition and the class assemblies. You participated in the spirit of a true DBIS student. I salute your zeal and enthusiasm, children. Just as baby Jesus was born and he grew in hardship, you too bore all the inconveniences and grew closer to your family, who were your support in the last few months. Your bright, confident smile never left you, and your love bound us together in the true spirit of the season. Christmas, dear children, is lived throughout the year, just as you have done, spreading goodwill and cheer. A Merry Christmas to all of you children and your families and all our staff members, and wishing you a very happy 2021 too. Thank you.
Thank you, Father Crispino and Meena ma'am, for your Christmas messages for all of us. Before we end, we have a treat in store.
And of course, we'd like to end on a high note.
No, not that note. What better note than Feliz Navidad, followed by a hope for 2020 with our very own Jerusalem Challenge.
Feliz Navidad.
Au kula na ki alikolana buso wami aukolana ilondoloze Alikolana buso wami aukolana ilondoloze zuhambe nami dawo yami alikolana buso wami aukolana ilondoloze
Every one of you
a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year 2021.
Good day.
God bless.
Keep smiling
and stay safe.
This is Tarun Moisuddin
and Shalom Mendes signing out.